Tampa Bay Lightning Hockey on Sun Sports is brought to you by Toyota, moving forward. By Steak and Shake, life needs flavor. And by your local Buick GMC dealers. Welcome back inside the St. Pete Times Forum as the crowd observing a moment of silence for Dan Weldon, resident of St. Petersburg, who passed away tragically yesterday in an accident at the IndyCar race in Las Vegas. We're now set for our national anthem as the crowd on its feet. Featuring 63 pipes, new to the building. Ray Horsley at the keyboard, getting us started with our national anthem as we meet the starting goaltenders for tonight's game of the Lightning and Panthers.
What a great start he has had, Jose Theodore. He's won two of the three games that they played, but look at the numbers. Great save percentage and goals against average. Dwayne Roloffson being in his fourth game at this point, he would love to get that save percentage up, which he will eventually. Kevin Dineen, the new coach for the Panthers, behind the bench after 6 years in the American League and 19 years in the league as a player. And Guy Boucher is second year behind the bench for the Lightning.
Same officials as the other night in South Florida, Brad Meyer, Kyle Raymond, the referees. That was Brad Meyer with the opening faceoff. Johnny Murray and Mark Wheeler are the linesmen as the Panthers won in South Florida their home opener on Saturday night. 3-2 in a shootout. Well, tonight's Lightning game presented in high definition here on Sun Sports, brought to you by H.H. Gregg, along with the Chief Bobby Taylor, Paul Kennedy, Dave Andrich, Chuck, Chris Dingman, Rick Peckham with you tonight, and glad you've joined us for this long-awaited night.
Fourth home opener Florida's been involved with. Islanders, Pittsburgh, their own, and now here tonight for the Lightning. Is that like having a homecoming team?
Well, Kevin Dineen says we should know how to handle the emotions of this game, our fourth one, including their own. They started the year with the Islander home opener, and then the Penguins, then their own, and now this one. They play tomorrow night in Washington against the Capitals. Dmitry Kulikov with a pass across to Jack Skilly, room to wind and fire, and he cranks it over the shoulder of Dwayne Roloffson. Marcel Gotch, who scored the game-deciding goal, the only one in the shootout, to provide that 3-2 winning margin for the Panthers. Lightning taking over with Vinny LeCavalier's pass, stolen by Gotch. Lightning in their new home blue uniforms. First look at them. Booth down the left side for the Panthers. Swings inside, lost the puck. It's flipped to center by Brett Connolly. Connolly playing in his sixth game. That's the Lightning with a decision to make. He can play nine games before they have to decide whether they keep him, and his contract starts as Roloffson kicks out that try from the corner or send him back to Prince George in the Western Hockey League in junior hockey. Thomas Kopetsky chased there by Eric Brewer. Puck comes out to the point. Jason Garrison shooting, and he missed the net. He followed the Lightning on our Sun Sports telecast in the past. I'm sure you're enjoying the brighter lighting in the building. One of the many, many enhancements in the $40 million renovation funded all by owner Jeff Fittick that are in the process of taking place, and they've been very busy handling that over the course of the summer. Puck knocked down by Marc-Andre Bergeron, getting to a Dominic Moore from the corner, fires, and Theodore in position to make the stop. Teddy Purcell with it, trying to lose Steven Weiss. Got Nate Thompson with him on this line. The pass goes behind the net. Pitching in from the point. Bergeron took the hit. Weiss has the puck. Out of the wing for Thomas Fleischman. Strong play by Matt Gilroy to hold it in. A pass hit Thompson. Vinny LeCavalier getting to it now. Purcell out of the corner. LeCavalier will let it go to Pavel Kabina. His shot knocked down. Puck is loose. And the Panthers move it ahead to Fleischman.
Both teams are kind of experimenting. Lightning have five new players. Florida has 11 new players. Talking to Kevin Dineen this morning, he's trying to get the feel for everybody, to get some chemistry for the lines. And they've done a pretty good job.
Bergenheim with a shot over the net. John Bergenheim, the former Lightning player, centers. It comes to the line, but held in by Kulikov. Around for Bergenheim, and he is barreled into there by Pavel Kabina. The puck underneath Bergenheim. Officials want play to continue, and it does. Mike Weaver paired with Kulikov, the 20-year-old, stepping out. Rolison handles that puck for Brett Clark. Marty St. Louis on the rush. He's got Steve Downey. Steven Stamkos with him. Stamkos in that zone. Matched up with Weaver. Tried to center. And Kulikov got a skate on it. On the point, Victor Hedman lobs it wide of the net. Downey chases it down. Lobs it back to Eric Brewer. He'll send it. It's tipped on goal. Backhand try. And St. Louis was stopped there by Theodore as Stamkos got the deflection as that puck made its way to St. Louis. Downey digs in along the boards. Involved in a high-energy bout with rookie defenseman Eric Gabranson on Saturday night. Gabranson with his height advantage at 6'4", and catching Downey a little unawares to start with. Landed some early punches, and Downey was able to get in tight and land a few at the end. That seemed to energize the Lightning in that second period. Puck ends up on Rolison, and he will cover, now being checked.
Even, but everybody on the team kind of figured that as well, and coaches as well. They thought that they were going to, that was what really sparked him in that game.
Ball standing by.
Hey, Rick, Chief, they're sparked tonight. They're really flying, aren't they? A patriotic touch this evening, quite inspiring before our national anthem. No less than Major General Carl Horsch, Chief of Staff, United States Army Central Command, played hockey at West Point, has served this nation for four decades, carrying Old Glory on skates around the ice. He presented it to the color guard, and then we sang the anthem tonight. General Horsch with us here at opening night inside the forum.
Great touch. Thanks, Paul. Well, the Lightning talked about developing depth. Chief and Staff Sergeant Thompson, he can help out.
I'll tell you what, he's got the size, Rick.
Bouncing puck in front of Rolison. Ryan Carter tapping it on goal, a save by Rolison. We've got a penalty upcoming. And the first call appears to be going against the Lightning at 4:35. Adam Hall heading off.
You're going to have to wait to see what his call is, but he came in here to clear the front porch. Oh, a cross-checking. That's what they're calling it. You see, it comes in here at 4:35. The puck lying around the crease, so you want to make sure. Where's the cross-checking? He hit him with his forearm. They're looking for things now. Florida gets the first power play. They had a ton of them in that game Saturday night. And that's what really kind of disrupted the flow for the Lightning. They're trying to stay out of the box.
They had a power play chance for the Panthers. It went 2 of 6 to jumpstart their power play to the season. And only one goal with a man advantage. And a couple of games prior to that, this shot is stopped by Brewer and flipped out. The Lightning had a perfect string of 21 straight kills coming into that game. And now have allowed 2 goals and 27 times short. But it's that 27, Chief, as you point out, that is concerning to the Lightning. Not only the fact that they're shorthanded that number of times, it really hurts their flow. Steven Stamkos was talking about, you know, you don't have the chance to go on the power play yourself when you're killing penalties all the time.
you know what? Most of your players now, your better players, don't kill that many penalties. You know, they got guys like Thompson and Hall and Nicola. You know, those are the kind of guys that kill a lot of the penalties. So they're off the ice for a long time. The top six players, the offensive
Brewer. Lifts the puck to the point. It's held in by Ed Jovanovski. He had one of those power play goals the other night. Has the puck here with the shot. It's deflected by Booth. And it goes wide of the net. Centered in front. The pass tipped by Thompson. Thomas Kopetsky. From a wing and Blackhawk. Acquired at the draft this summer. Campbell with a pass across. And Kopetsky getting it once again to Jovanovski. Pass deflected. Jovanovski saving it. Kopetsky closing in, resting, and he scores! Thomas Kopetsky scores a Panther power play goal at 6:15 to open the scoring in this hockey game.
And again, it's the Panthers' power play has still been a thorn on the side of this Lightning hockey club. They have not been a very good power play team throughout the last couple of years, but they seem to score a ton with a man advantage. They got their first two, as Rick pointed out, in the game Saturday. Now they get the first goal of the game. It actually deflected off a stick in front. Watch, it hits Brewer's stick right there. And deflects past Rollinson. They'll get credit with that goal. 1-0 Panthers.
Marc-Andre Bergeron is paired with Matt Gilroy, who re-entered the lineup for Saturday's game. And Guy Boucher saying this morning he was happy with his game. He said he needed to calm it down, not play as complicated as he had earlier, but felt he was happy with how Gilroy played. He's back in tonight as the Lightning try to bounce back after surrendering the power play goal. Front 1-0. Well, just like the fan, the players are excited about all the renovations here at the St. Pete Times Forum and finally getting to play in front of the home crowd, as Steven Stamkos told us this morning.
You know, it was a tough road trip. It didn't go the way we wanted to, obviously, but it's good to be back home and see the great changes here at the rink and the excitement of the town, and can't wait to play in front of our fans. You know, the last game we played in front of them was last year in the playoffs, and it was an amazing experience. So hopefully it's the same thing tonight and a good result.
Tough start, though, with that deflected power play goal by Kopetsky, but I think that's something the Lightning right now, they've always played with a lot of poise and confidence, and I think that confidence might be a little shaken at this point. They need something good to happen to start regaining that swagger.
Now we've got Gabranson and Ryan Malone squaring off, hitting the helmets off, and Malone works with the right hand early. I think the Lightning felt down. He was occupied the other night with Jovanovski and got taken by surprise by Gabranson, obviously much bigger, and took advantage of that. Now Malone losing his jersey here. And Gabranson, the third overall pick last year, a tough reputation, but we know certainly Malone and Downey can handle themselves. And Malone landing a couple there as the linesmen move in.
Well, Gabranson come up from behind and grabbed Downey from behind when he was jabbing with Jovanovski. That's what got him the instigator penalty. And this one, right now, you're talking, Malone's talking with him right off the bat, and they just dropped their gloves. And we talked about how that fight with Downey and Gabranson on Saturday night kind of sparked this Lightning hockey club. And we'll see how that happens here with just about 6 minutes into this.
Shots three apiece at this point. They each get five for fighting.
You have to wait for that. You never know how they're going to react to that because to see what they're going to call.
So coincidental major penalties, and the team skated full strength as Brian Campbell dumps the puck in. Brewer back for it. Checked by Chris Versteeg. Campbell holding it in. He played nearly 30 minutes of the game the other night. And that's been just about his average, Chiefs. It's Kevin Dineen got his hands on him in that Florida lineup. He must like what he sees.
One thing that's amazing to me, Rick, is he's not has the most ice time in the league. I think he's about third.
He is behind Dan Girardi of the Rangers by a few seconds, and it's Thomas Fleischmann who goes off here at 7:26.
Fleischmann, I believe, will get a tripping call on this call, and the Lightning will get their first crack with the man advantage. This is something that everybody would like to see, the power play to start working for them, getting a little bit more offense on it. You know, most coaches like it if they move the puck around and they get a lot of pressure and all, but it looks like Downey's going as well.
Well, Downey was headed toward the box. Johnny Murray says, "Where are you going?" And Downey says, "I got a skate issue here." And I think he might be getting a misconduct, in which case he can go to the locker room. Hooking to Fleischmann. So a misconduct for him. But the Lightning get the power play opportunity. They scored twice in opening night. Goals by LeCavalier and Downey. Since then, they've gone 14 straight without a goal. Here's a save by Theodore, and the St. Louis shot immediately. And we get another stoppage in play.
One thing that we noticed on Saturday evening, the Panthers, Theodore will give you the rebound. And that's the thing the Lightning have to really get to. They didn't get to them too often in that game down in Sunrise. But tonight is a big factor. They must get to those rebounds. They're going to be there.
Panthers have been shorthanded only 9 times coming in. They've killed all 9 penalties. Gotch in this faceoff. Pulls it back to Weaver, and they slip it by Brett Clark and back down the ice. So Clark and St. Louis open up as the point men. Matias Rotola working with Stamkos and LeCavalier up front. Here comes Clark. He scored 6 power play goals among his 9 last year. LeCavalier into the corner. Rotola trying to get there, working with LeCavalier. Rotola controls it, couldn't get it by Gotch. Finally back to St. Louis. Walks in, fires, and he sends it wide. Puck is on edge, chopped out in front, and it comes back to St. Louis. Lightning get it set up now. Rotola in front. Usually you'd find Ryan Malone there, but he's serving the major penalty. St. Louis fakes the shot. Back to Rotola. Clark in the slot. He scored a number of those power play goals last year from there. St. Louis shooting. A save by Theodore. And that was deflected. John Bergenheim coming up with it. Gotch will clear it out.
One of the things you got to be careful of when you're struggling with the man advantage is you got to still show your poise and patience. And sometimes you're trying to do too much.
Brett Connolly, the 19-year-old, getting to the puck. Kopetsky steals, and it's fired down the ice by Sean Matthias. 34 seconds left in the Fleischmann call. I think you can extend that to a number of the areas for the Lightning, Chief. The fact that they're trying a little too hard sometimes. As Purcell moving it in, he and Ryan Shannon back in the lineup for Tom Pyatt and Blair Jones for this game, and they see action on the second power play unit. Shannon. Connolly's in front. Bergeron watched closely by Matthias. Panthers learn their lesson there. Here's Purcell out in front. They score! With only 4 seconds to go, the power play. The Lightning connect. Connolly was reaching for that puck. Did he tip it in before it rolled in on the shot by Purcell?
We'll have to wait for the official on it, but it looks like it. If not, it was a wide, bad angle goal coming off the corner of the rink. Watch how they move it down. Teddy Purcell takes the shot. No, I think it's going to be Purcell's goal all the way because it rebounded off or deflected off a person in front. And you see it right here. Watch the shot come right there to hit the defenseman. I believe that was Campbell's stick. And the Lightning will get tie this game on their power play goal.
Got it up at 1. Victor Hedman back for the puck. Hedman playing better than 26 minutes the other night in that shootout loss in Sunrise. Errant pass will carry the length. We'll get a touch up for icing.
Well, it's good to see that you get that power play. Let's take another look at it. We'll show you
when Purcell comes out of the corner, you'll take a look. Watch now. There's Campbell coming right there. And it was actually over the line before Townley really was able to jam it through. See his stick. It's going to be right there. You see it coming right in through there. And it goes in before Conley gets it. So I believe it's going to be Purcell. That'll be number two for Teddy if it is.
Bergeron, St. Louis, and Purcell, each with two goals, leading the Lightning as Hedman shoots it in. Paul trying to get to that puck, pulls his way right into the corner with Kulikov. Puck angled off Matt Bradley's stick to center, and the Lightning will start once again. Paul deflects it in, but not very far. Kulikov out to Bradley. He's on with Upshaw. Gilroy reaching for the puck. Playing it back for Bergeron. Out for Adam Hall. Jason Garrison there waiting for him. It is Purcell's goal. Shannon and Bergeron pick up the assists. Marc-Andre Bergeron now with 6 points to lead the Lightning. Garrison. Pounded here by Stamkos, who tipped the puck. Trying to get to it. Deflects in front, controlled by Campbell. And Hedman's try bounced off Versteeg, but Brewer was backing the play up. Gave it up to Fleischman. Here come the Panthers. Now Versteeg cutting and shooting. Saved by Rolison. Rebound cleared away by Brewer. Weiss shoved to the boards by Rotola. Rotola had a stick lifted by Versteeg. Versteeg is dumped by Hedman as Brewer. Chased out by Weiss. His pass hit Fleischman. Rotola tips that puck to center. Lightning want to start to get a change going here. So do the Panthers. Lead pass by Campbell as well in front of Booth. And Brewer gets rid of it. Out for Marty St. Louis. Handing it to the rookie Brett Campbell. Conley, who picked up an assist, his first NHL point in Washington last week. But looking for that first NHL goal. And the play is whistled down offside. 8:29 to go. First period. The Lightning respond on the goal by...
And as play resumes, we are going to step in and visit with Ben Carpenter. Ben, you must be thrilled this evening.
Yes, sir. This is probably the biggest honor I've ever had, and I'm loving being here.
We mentioned junior achievement. What makes junior achievement near and dear to your heart?
Well, when I was in fifth grade, I went to their BizTown, which is pretty much a way for children to experience entrepreneurship in elementary school. And they really taught me a lot of life lessons that I can take forward. They taught me how to be a self-sustaining citizen. And they do that to all sorts of children. They, whether you're disadvantaged or you're just a normal kid, they want to help you succeed in life when you're an adult.
Well, thank you, Ben. Congratulations to you and Junior Achievement. Rick in Chief, he also is the captain of his wheelchair soccer team, the Tampa Thunder. You got to love that name.
Absolutely. Thanks, Paul, and congratulations to Ben. The Lightning are on the power play. Their second opportunity with Thomas Kopetsky off for tripping. And 56 seconds remaining on that chance, and here comes Marty St. Louis to center. Stamkos. Le Cavalier, one touching to the corner. Jason Garrison got it loose. Around for Marcel Gotch. Gotch, one of 11 new faces in the Panther lineup. They're whistled in the offside. 40 seconds remaining on this power play chance for the Lightning.
Wow, when they asked Ben to be the Thunder, I guess he's could be right there. He's plays for that soccer team called.
That's right.
He definitely
literally
is. Literally the Thunder. But the power play much more poised now. That it's amazing when it happens when you get that one goal. And it wasn't a pretty goal. It was a goofy goal because it's deflected in off of Campbell. But nonetheless, it counts. And Boucher's constantly talking about that. Those big fancy plays that get you about 3% of your goals that you see on SportsCenter all the time. That's what all you remember. But it's the ugly goals that win you the games that you score the most of.
Garrison backhands the puck on his own net. And Theodore got his stick on that, centered by Le Cavalier. The puck bounced to St. Louis. Back to Vinny for the quick one-timer from a tough angle. And he swung and missed. The puck cleared out through the legs of St. Louis with 13 seconds to go on the Panther penalty. So they surrender their first power play goal. 10 times short. Now this being the 11th. The shots are 7-4. Favoring the Lightning in this game. Tied at one. Out of the box comes Kopetsky. The backhand feed from Le Cavalier to Brewer. Lobbing it in on goal. Stopped by Theodore. He lost track of it. Kopetsky finds it. Theodore was standing up looking behind him and no idea where the puck was. And the Panthers, fortunately for him, were the players nearest the puck. And it was moved out. Here's Thompson turning the corner. Goes forehand. Theodore the save. Puck loose again. Hall. Hedman scores! The Lightning pounce on that loose puck. They lead 2-1.
It was set up by Thompson taking the puck more as well. He went around the outside of Jovanovski, again, the rebound, what we talked about. They were able to stay on that puck. Watch this, Foxbowl right there, finding that far corner with a quick wrist shot. And Victor Hedman picks up number one on the year to give the Lightning the lead here in the first period. But they attacked that blue line with speed, more along with Thompson, and created the rebound and the goal for Hedman.
John Mathias steps inside of the attempted hit by Bergeron. Got separated from his hockey stick. The puck backhanded out. And it looks like a delay of game call to the Lightning.
Green Victor Hedman, and we talked about him in the pregame show, Rick, and this is something that you really see in the first five games. He's been unbelievable. That look at the ice time. That's the best on the Lightning in average ice time. And one more hit out there as well, but he's done everything out there. 20 years old. He hasn't turned 21. I don't think, when's that come? December?
Yep, December.
So he's still a young man. And this is his third year in the league. He's going to be a monster.
I like the way he called for that puck, too. He saw the opening in the slot, went right to it, banged that stick on the ice. He wants to have the responsibility. Matt Gilroy picks up the penalty for delay of game. Of give and go here. Weiss is stopped. Puck cleared out. Adam Hall, a smart play there, and he got it ahead to Thompson. Thompson chasing after that rolling puck, trying to get it by Fleischman. Second power play chance for the Panthers. They capitalized on their first one on the goal by Kopetsky. Rolison has to let that puck go. Versteeg, checked by Hedman. Fired away by Hall. Lightning will go for a change. 35 seconds into this penalty. Shots 10-5 Lightning. Pass right to Brett Clark. Trying to send in Dominic Moore. He got bumped there by Brian Campbell. Kulikov from center. Handing it now to Scotty Upshaw. Kicked away by Moore. Couldn't clear it away. Booth came up with it. Centers in front. Upshaw was checked in the slot. Here's Kulikov shooting, and it's blocked by Clark. Ryan Shannon, who came up with that body check in the slot to prevent the try toward the net, clears it out. Fresh legs back on. Garrison handing it to Kopetsky. Kabina off the glass. Jovanovski had it taken away by Thompson. Bounced off his stick, and the Panthers regroup. 36 seconds to go on the call against Gilroy. Kopetsky reaching back for that puck. Jovanovski steps in. Angles it off the end glass. And it apparently bounced up, hit the netting, and then came back into play. Lightning opening week continues here at the St. Pete Times Forum with the Islanders on Thursday night at 7:30. The Sabres Saturday night at 7. Be the Thunder behind the Lightning. Get your tickets now by calling 800-745-3000 or visit Ticketmaster.com.
Penalty kill has been tremendous for this Lightning Hockey Club. They did give up the first two power play goals of the year against these Panthers on Saturday, but they've been a very aggressive penalty killing team. And that's been a big factor in their success.
St. Louis stepped in front of that pass. I think he took that pass by Jovanovski off the ankle. He's feeling that a little bit. Clark spilled near the Lightning bench. And Gilroy now out of the box. Tampa Bay kills the penalty, protecting a 2-1 lead. Brewer's going to get a hooking call on Gabranson. Delayed call. Gabranson shooting, and it's deflected away by Clark. And the puck controlled by Stamkos. And we'll get the call as the parade to the box continues at 16:21.
A lot of penalties. That's the thing you got to really be careful of. These guys here called a ton of penalties against them in Florida. You've got to be aware of that again here, that they're going to just keep doing it. So hooking will be the call.
Not much you can say about that one. Hall and Thompson do get the assists on Hedman's first goal to the 14-minute mark. The lead goal in this game. Panthers right back with a man advantage. The shot by Fleischman was blocked. Lightning coming in with 92 blocked shots, leading the league before play tonight.
They get a lot of them on the penalty kill. They've been shorthanded an awful lot.
Versteeg. They've got Weiss parked in front of Rolison. Versteeg with a pass, reaching Fleischman. Dominic Moore out there defending in the goal mouth now. Versteeg looking for Weiss, who was kicked away. And Campbell gets it back of the point. Across for Kulikov. Weiss, their leading scorer last year with 49 points. There's a shot that's sent wide by Fleischman. His stick disrupted just enough to force that shot wide. Kulikov winding, faking. Weiss shooting, he scores! Steven Weiss drills it home off the pass, and the Panthers twice have scored with a man advantage to tie this game.
This one is short side from an angle. As you point out, Rick, their second power play goal and three opportunities, but look, it comes down there, pass to Weiss. See it right there? That's short side. That shouldn't happen from that face-off dot. Take the slow hand of seat. Look at all the room you got right here.
Well, Weiss scores his second goal of the new season. Malone, obviously we've seen Gabranson have finished serving their major penalties. That shot by Gotch, scooped up by Rolison. He'll hang on with 2:34 remaining in this first period, and the game tied at two. Tampa Bay Lightning Hockey and Sun Sports is brought to you by Patrick's, where nobody wants to know your name.
You don't have to be famous to go in there, because they're not worried about that. Great sports bar, brand new kitchen, great hockey bar.
Chief's gear hanging in the rafters. What more do you want? That's where Chief wants that gear, hanging in the rafters. Now Weiss scoring from Kulikov and Campbell at 17-13 to tie it up. Weaver drives it in off the glass. Bergenheim and Purcell, playoff heroes together for the Lightning last year, contesting for that loose puck now. Marc-Andre Bergeron, his pass deflected by Bergenheim. Weaver working now at Jovanovski, just under 2 minutes to go. First period, Weaver drives it in. Upshaw and St. Louis were tangling down the boards. The puck is played to the point, and Jovanovski kept it on the line. Clark fires it now to Brett Connolly. Connolly through center, looking to place that puck in the corner. Deflected away, and Campbell sends it off the glass. Hit the glass support, stayed down for Connolly. Looking in behind the net for Stamkos. St. Louis with it. Fires the pass to Clark. He'll fire. Knocked down in front by Campbell. Connolly kept the play alive for Stamkos and St. Louis. Kabina down the boards. Lewandowski started to take a run at him there, but missed him, and Kubi kept going, and out come the Panthers. Lead pass for the speedy David Booth. Clark checks him into the boards. A minute remaining here in the opening period. St. Louis works against Bradley, the former Capital. Thompson chips it in, continues on. Lightning changing up ice. They'll try to occupy Gabranson, who was stepped into there by Steve Downey. No introduction needed there. Downey serving his 10-minute misconduct. Mathias feeding through, stopped by Rolison. Hangs on to it now. 36 and a half seconds to go in the period.
Yeah, they're a little deflated on that power play goal. The penalty kill being so good. You've seen now four power play goals scored by this Florida team. And watch this play as it comes around, right through the middle. Not a whole lot of room there on the short side, and Rolison covered it up quite well, and Hedman had lost his stick on that rush. Dominic Moore, who's taken a lot of faceoffs so far and has won a ton of them.
Brewer chips it out. Gabranson checked there by Thompson. And Moore getting to the puck. And we get a hand pass indication. Let's look ahead to the intermission with our Buick GMC first intermission report. Teddy Purcell will join Paul Kennedy downstairs outside the Lightning room. We'll have a sit-down interview with the owner of the Lightning, Jeff Finnick, get his thoughts early in the new season. And with the opening of the redesigned and refurbished St. Pete Times Forum, Dinger and Andy join Paul, and we'll have Chief on the telestrator. A lot coming up, so don't go away between periods. Brewer, now with Versteeg spinning off the check. Downey picks up the puck. Hedman in there with 11 seconds to go in the period. Downey wants to keep it there. Panthers work it free. Garrison with a shot that blazed wide. Weaver puts it behind the net. Downey there. Weiss trying to pry it loose. The horn sounds, ending the first period of play. Now the power plays have been busy and they've been successful. Victor Hedman has the only even strength goal of the period. Kopetsky and Weiss scoring with a man advantage for Florida. Teddy Purcell with a Lightning power play goal, and the shots at officially 10-8 Tampa Bay. Brought to you by your local Buick GMC dealers up here in our Sun Sports booth, high above the ice. Chief, both power plays clicking. That certainly can be a source of confidence for any hockey team.
It really can, Rick, and the one thing they have to be aware of, though, is you got to try and stay out of the penalty box because both teams' power play is working extremely hard. We're going to see in our highlights here some really good defense, though, when you have been shorthanded, and it's by Adam Hall. You see, as the Panthers get the play in here, what I want you to do is watch Adam Hall right here. Watch his head. He keeps an eye on Versteeg right there. Take a look at how he works. See, there it is. He looks and sees him there. The puck goes in the corner. He looks and sees him there again. It's important because here comes the play in here. Now, you know he's got to come back. He knows exactly that Versteeg is here. Hall has to come in to get that loose puck, and he does a real good job of it. Watch. He knows exactly where Versteeg is because he kept taking a look around to see where everybody was. He was able to clear that rebound and then, of course, get the play out of trouble as well and then get it up to the offensive zone. But really good defense by Adam Hall there and being aware of where everybody was on the ice at that time. Now the power play, this is another good play. See the quick transition? That's what you like to see, that really good pass up the middle. Then Moore gets it one to Thompson. The key thing of it is, watch Thompson now. As he takes it to the outside, that's going to be Kirby. Jovanovski's here. He just can't seem to turn quickly enough. Thompson shows his speed. Now as he dives to get him, look at that left foot. It protects the puck with that from that diving stick. He comes in and jams that puck loose, or tries to. The puck's going to lose head up there. You see Hall. Now you see right in here is where Hedman is going to be jamming his stick. See, watch it, banging his stick so he's wide open. Now as he takes the shot, he has to get it by this man right here. It just has to go definitely by it. It does. Hits the post and in the net. Hedman's first of the year. The Lightning take the 2-1 lead on that goal, but then it was the power play again. Only this time it's kind of one that I'm sure Rollison would like to have back. But see where he is. He's out here. He has to take a look at the guy up here. He has to stay out there to see till that puck moves. Fakes the shot. He's still out there. He sees it well. Now they pass it over. As he gets across, the one-timer, there's a lot of room right here. But I think with Brett Clark right here, might have taken his vision away from the puck just a hair. And Rollie's a little slow to move to the short side. High shot by Weiss, his second of the year, ties the hockey game on the power play.
Our first period stats brought to you by your local Buick GMC dealers, and the shots favoring the Lightning 10-8. Scoring chances, Panthers with the edge there. And they had three power plays to two for the Lightning, both finding the mark there with a man advantages, and the faceoffs were even. Let's check out our Ottawa poll question for tonight. What will be the best part of the Forum's renovation? If you believe the pipe organ, we've heard a lot of that so far. TB1, the Tesla coils. TB2, new seats. TB3, TB4, the outdoor party deck. Text your choice to 789-789. We'll show you the results in Lightning Live immediately following the game.
I know what my vote is.
The Tesla coils. The new seats, too.
Yeah, I think it's that party deck.
Oh, okay. Okay,
that kind of, that's the one that might just get up. Might just edge out the new seats.
Okay. We're ready to go for period number two. Ryan Campbell playing about 9 minutes in that first period. Chops the puck to center. He's got 5 assists on the season already for the Panthers. In just 4 games, and 4 of those assists have been in the power play. He's helped out in all 4 of their power play goals this year. Lightning penalty upcoming. Versteeg across the line, still with it. Dipsy doodling, finding Fleischman, waiting, feeding it. Harrison walks in and missed the net. However, the Panthers still have it. Sent by Kopetsky out to the point. Brian Campbell under the delayed penalty signal. Fleischman's pass tipped and the Lightning control. Brad Myers got a call to the 46-second mark, and it's a trip.
I'm telling you, you can't go near anybody. We're going to have ice capades very, very quickly. Nate Louis will pick up the penalty for tripping. And again, the Lightning shorthanded for the fourth time.
Panthers get it from the faceoff. Toyota power play chance for them. That's a stat that's been good for both teams and a key to why they've been successful with a man advantage. Both have been sharp on the faceoffs on their power plays. That's the Panthers 3 of 3 on faceoffs with a man advantage, and the Lightning were 2 of 4 in that first period. Garrison across to Jovanovski. Kopetsky takes it. 15 goal man for the Hawks last year. Jovanovski defers now to Jason Garrison. Garrison will take the one-timer, and he blisters that wide, and around it comes to Kopetsky. Lightning have Hall and Thompson out to kill the penalty. Here's a shot by Booth, a save by Rollison. Upshaw hurries after that puck. Clark and Kabina work defensively for the Lightning. Jovanovski beating it out of Kopetsky. Wrist shot knocked down in front. And Garrison shooting, save Rollison. Covers the puck with the help of Clark. 1:03 to go on the penalty to St. Louis. And Upshaw getting involved with Hall just a bit. The linesman calmed them down.
One of the things that you got to really be able to do is move quickly from side to side. And Panthers really moved that puck around fast. And Rolly was able to get over there, not only to get that initial shot, but to get the second one as well.
Clark blocking that shot there. It's his third of the game. He's got 21 already this season. Leading the NHL, Weiss closing in, shooting, blocker save by Rollison, bouncing puck, and Shannon had to wait for it to make contact with it. Now he's battling Weiss along the boards with Kulikov. Hedman joins the tussle, and it's cleared out, in and out of the Panther bench. 42 seconds, 41 seconds, the clock's still running. They're going to have to reset the clock here. As
take a look at those block shot leaders in the league. And you see this upturn, Clark taking the lead over a former Panther. Now in Carolina, Hammerlick, Blum, Seidenberg. But Clark always is amongst the leaders in block shots. His timing is pretty good.
No shortage of bravery, too. Stepping in front of those shots.
Lightning got to start getting that puck down a little faster. They took their time. Their biggest problem is they're trying to get the puck down slowly or even trying to make a play. And that's what's creating all the pressure in their zone.
Shannon without a stick. Hedman broke his, and Shannon gave his a pass across. They score! Christine capitalized on the Weiss pass, a one-timer, and a third Panther power play goal.
Well, I tell you what, this Versteeg has just been using that side. We see Stamkos from there a lot. But take a look, he breaks a stick, and then you'll see Shannon handing it to him, and now you've got to move around. And he's a right-handed shot. Hedman's a left-handed shot, so it's an awkward stick for him. As you see the curves going the other way, there comes the shot, the one-timer. Versteeg has that wide-open side, and he buries it.
Victor 6'6", Shannon 5'9". I'm sure it's a considerably shorter hockey stick as well. And you saw Victor reaching to get a piece of that pass. Perhaps he might have gotten to it had he had his own lumber in his hand. Skilly, now to Gotch firing, and it's blocked at the point of attack there by Teddy Purcell. The Cavalier's pass ricochets back to Bergeron. Nearly 3 minutes gone here in the second period, and the Panthers have struck with a man advantage again. They were 1 for 10 on the power play in their first two games. Versteeg scoring here from Weiss, and yet again, Brian Campbell. And the Panthers I believe 5-for-10 on the power play since their first two games. Just in this home and home set with the Lightning.
Well, Rick, they've had 13 shots on goal unofficially. 10 of them have come with the man advantage.
Connolly brings the play in. Le Cavalier beat the play at the line in the opinion of Johnny Murray, and the play is blown dead. 10-game Little Caesars Lightning packs are on sale now. Get tickets to 10 of the Lightning's biggest home games for as low as $179 a 10-pack. Plus, you'll get a free large hot and ready pizza from Little Caesars with any 10-pack purchase. Get your tickets now by calling 813-301-6600 or visit TampaBayLightning.com. Malone will take this draw against Ryan Carter. And Rotola and Mathias jousting at the side of the circle. Malone gets it on goal where it's kicked out by Theodore. Matt Bradley has Carter driving the net. And the shot was blocked yet again by Clark. Jovanovski shoots. That's blocked by Malone. Jovanovski gets it back. Jovanovski, a first overall pick by the Panthers back in 1994, returning for the first time since 99 in their lineup. He was traded to Vancouver in the Pavel Bure deal in the late 90s. Kubina hustles his man Mathias along the boards. Carter gets away, slips in. Clark blocked the shot. Malone getting it ahead for Dominic Moore. He'll take on Kulikov. Gabranson. Puck deflected by Upshaw. Gilroy pressured by Booth, and he marches right past him as well as Scotty Upshaw to center. Kulikov takes over, fans on his pass, dug loose by Steve Downey. Downey bumps with Kulikov. Kulikov checked by Stamkos and dropped. Kopetsky and Booth try to move it up ice. Downey throws a hip into David Booth, and the Lightning hold it in. Steven Stamkos back down the boards where it's retrieved by Weaver. Stamkos gets involved again. Weaver has it once again. Kopetsky slides it back through center. Bergeron will get to it. That's 13-11 now favoring the Panthers. 5-1 Florida, helped by that early power play opportunity and the play they scored on. Here's St. Louis cutting and shooting. Saved by Theodore. Hardy gets it back. Hardy swings in front. Chased by Weaver. Working it to Le Cavalier. Interrupted by Fleischman. That's St. Louis' fourth shot on goal among the 12 the Lightning have as the play is whistled down.
Bergeron shooting it in, and he hit it right off one of the Lightning players who were caught inside there. But the one thing about it, when the team is clicking on the power play, it takes away a lot of your aggressiveness. Here's a nice pass that Marty played very well off the boards. There's the first shot. You see the rebound coming right out there. They just couldn't get anybody loose in front. As the Panthers got back very, very quickly to cover up in the neutral zone, and, or in the slot area, rather. Kevin Dineen talked about that this morning, saying how he was, they have to get everybody back there. He didn't think they were going to score a whole lot of goals, so they have to play very, very good team defense.
Campbell, three assists in this game, all with a man advantage. Makes his way to center. Campbell only had 28 points last year with Chicago in 65 games on that big long-term contract for 3 years with the Blackhawks and helped them win a cup in 2010. Dale Talon, the general manager, bringing him to South Florida for Rostislav Olesh. And the wraparound try by Gotch is stopped there by Rolison. Gotch gets it back. Working with Bergenheim, put in center, Clark steals. Gotch gets it once again. Thompson takes it. Four-man rush into the zone. Thompson stood up at the defense by Campbell. Lead pass for Jack Skilly, batted away by Purcell. Rollison leaving it for Brewer. Thompson across for Le Cavalier. The pass, it escapes. Purcell takes it. He's got Vinny with him. Purcell shooting, a save there by Theodore. Tricky move and the toe drag by Purcell. The shot on the point by Brewer. Rebound try. Theodore saved there on Rotola. Panthers three man back. Bradley on the wing closing and shooting. Saved there by Rollison. By Elias spilled in front on the collision with Rotola. The pass taken away. Carter trying to get it on goal. Rollison desperate to cover. He does. 13:02 remaining in the second period. Versteeg scoring on the power play, giving the Panthers
our Ottawa replay. It involves Teddy Purcell trying to pick up his second goal of the game. Watch how he moves across, takes that quick shot. Big save by Theodore. Lightning keep it in, and then look at this, another rebound opportunity, but this time Theodore shows his quickness, gets across and makes a big save on Rotola to prevent the Lightning from tying that game. We talked about the rebounds that he has given out, Theodore, but boy, that time there, he has really showed how quickly he recovered to make that save on a rebound opportunity.
Shots even at this point of the game, 15 each. The Panthers have the edge in the scoreboard, 3-2 for the moment. Here's Kulikov to shoot it in. Rollison tees it up for Victor Hedman. Out comes Downey. His pass knocked down by Versteeg. Weiss looks to re-enter. Kulikov on the attack with him. Sliding it through. It's off the side of the goal. Weiss with it. Trying to lose Hedman. Now he's got St. Louis on the scene. Stamkos gets involved. Lightning gain control. And it's St. Louis to center. Already hitting the 300 goal plateau early in that road trip, as he scored in each of the first two games on the trip in Carolina and in Boston. Stamkos matched up with Weaver. Weaver, former college teammate of Adam Hall at Michigan State for a couple of years. Gilroy back. Ryan Shannon stepping into the zone, angles it behind the net. Weaver got his stick on it. It was intended for Rotola. Scotty Upshaw swinging in, reaching back. Bergeron just tapped the puck away from Kopetsky.
Nice back checking by Hall. He saw that Gilroy was going to pinch in there. He just dropped back to take that defensive spot. Really a nice play.
Lightning have made a couple of nice plays defensively in the last couple of rushes, Chief, and the coaches always say this is where your offense starts from. This is where you generate things. We'll see what comes of it from here. Ball shoveling it behind the net. He's matched up with Carter, dropped his stick. It's chopped back to the point. Campbell winding and firing wide. Ball getting to it. Sails it out to center. Ryan Malone tapping it ahead. Jason Garrison, who played about 27 minutes the other night in South Florida. Kevin Dineen obviously likes what he sees from him. Puck centered by Mathias. Jovanovski stepping off the Panther bench. With Gabranson, his shot deflected in wide as it hit Connolly in the slot. Bradley tried to poke it out in front. It's taken away. Mathias with it.
Lightning are tired right now. They've only got a partial change out there. They still got a lot of guys that were still out there from the last shift. They need to get some fresh bodies out there.
LeBranson moving it to his veteran partner, Jovanovski, taken away by Dominic Moore. The race on. LeBranson getting there. Jovanovski takes over. A 35-year-old defenseman lobbing it back to center. Clark waits for that puck to settle down. Panthers change it up. Clark's pass reaching Thompson at the line. Moore slips through. Dominic Moore swings it in front off Theodore in the slot. It comes loose to Weaver. He is pummeled by Thompson as it sent down the ice. We reach the 10-minute mark of the second period. Skelly on a steal, walks in, shoots, and Rollison the save. The Panthers leading three power play goals. The Lightning have had a goal from Purcell with a man advantage. And an even string, Tom Hastings, our director of our Sun Sports telecast and also the Tampa Bay Rays as well. His mother, Doris, just passed away, and Tom is back with his family. Doris raising Tom and his brothers in the Toronto area. She was born in Newfoundland and will be buried there. And our thoughts and prayers are with Tommy, his family, from everybody, from the crew working here tonight. Not only that, but throughout the Sun Sports organization and Fox Sports Florida as well. Tom has been an integral part of our telecast for many, many years. Panthers get it from the faceoff. Marcel Gotch checked. Try there. Taken by Bergenheim. Stopped by Rollison in the backhand. And away comes Nate Thompson. Vinny LeCavalier with him. The pass behind Vinny. Weaver saw it coming, flicked it away, and Jack Skilly for the Panthers trying to step inside on Clark. Gets to the puck in the corner. Bergenheim and Thompson jousting for position. Teddy Purcell, he's got one of the Lightning goals, swinging in on the backhand. And like what he saw there in front, he'll hang on to it, defended by Kulikov, handing it down to Thompson. As we've got a delayed penalty to the Panthers upcoming, the pass through to Hedman, shooting, and it's deflected off Theodore and wide. Here's Le Cavalier. Lightning still gain control of that puck. They've got six skaters on. Stamkos joining this group. Le Cavalier handing it to St. Louis. Stamkos out of the corner, firing in front, knocked down. Panthers now gain control, and we'll get the call at 11:14 of the second.
The initial signal by Raymond is for holding. And it looks like it's going to be Kulikov. Let's take a look at that chance again. Lightning and good aggressive puck control by Nate Thompson. There the shot was actually deflected a little bit in the slot area. Or else that puck would have come to Victor Hedman a little cleaner. He had to wait for a little bit. With that little extra time to wait, it created a chance for Theodore to get over there.
Lightning ended an 0-for-14 stretch in the power play with a goal by Purcell midway through the first. Here's Kopetsky shorthanded. His shot blocked by Clark. Still causing problems in deep in that Lightning zone. Tampa Bay 1-of-2 so far on the night with the power play. Stamkos. Lead pass for St. Louis. Rotola's with him. Rotola back to Marty. And his shot is tipped by Garrison. Rotola gets it free in front. Le Cavalier trying to slide it to the point. Couldn't get much on it with Garrison defending. And it's Weiss and Kopetsky 2-on-2. Weiss sneaks a shot through. It's blockered away by Rollerson. 1:15 remaining on the holding call to Kulikov. Stamkos continues on. Pressured by Mathias, finds Dominic Moore. Malone chipping it back for Bergeron, and it's poked away. A breakaway for Bergenheim. Bergenheim on Rollison, fake shoot, scores. Sean Bergenheim, a shorthanded goal, and the Panthers have a 4-2 lead.
We've seen this team now. They are very, very aggressive when that puck goes back to the point, and they fed it back to him, and there's a bouncing puck and Bergeron trying to control it. Bergeron very quick to get on it. Really a nice shoulder fake, then put it up top. Shorthanded. It'll be an unassisted goal here at 12:17. And it's a two-goal lead for the Panthers.
He had 14 goals in the regular season with the Lightning last year. None of them shorthanded.
He had a few shorthanded breakaways, though.
He sure did.
But he didn't show that move.
Cutting in Malone, firing off the post. Purcell has it. Lightning continue with 40 seconds to go in the power play. Purcell gets it set up, closing in. Downey, he's got a power play goal here in the early season. Gabina, watched by Ryan Carter. One-timer ripped on goal there by Bergeron. A save by Theodore. Pops out in front. Campbell has it. They send it off the glass down the ice. 15 seconds remaining on the Kulikov penalty. Pavel Kabina on the move. Downey gives it back to him. Hedman has room to walk in. Looks for a stick and he fires it wide as Connolly and Downey were both in front. Penalty over. Downey behind the net. Spins away from Weaver. Pops it in front, but it bounced off Matt Bradley. And Kulikov will ease it down the ice. Panthers look for a change. Bradley with the pressure. Well, their fourth line chief really skates well.
That's the thing. That's what we talked about, Rick, is how the Lightning were so good last year because of those that third or fourth line, so to speak. They had a lot of energy, a lot of speed. And right now, Florida's enjoying that from theirs.
Got a look at the Lightning's road ahead, brought to you by Toyota.
Lightning will be home for two more. Thursday, Islanders, Saturday, Buffalo, before they go back out on the road for two. In Buffalo on the Tuesday, Thursday, in Nashville, and then back home here on the Saturday night against the Winnipeg Jets. First look at the, not a new team, but new version of the Winnipeg Jets, because the Atlanta Thrashers moving there.
Gilroy for the point, chops it to the corner, races on. DeBranson had a head start. Edmund poked it loose. Connolly with it. Moore looks to re-enter. Draws attention from Trulikoff. Brett Connolly in the corner. Connolly spins it back. Quick shot. Theodore the save there. The try by Ryan Shannon. And he's watched closely by Moore. We get the stoppage. 5:55 remaining. And it's Dammer's work here at the St. Pete Times Forum last year. 52 points. He and Marty St. Louis tied for the most points at home in the NHL. Very impressive dossier there for Steven Stamkos.
Big reason why the Lightning won 25 home games, which is tied for the lead in the Eastern Conference.
And tied a club record set in 2006 by the Lightning of that year. Victor Hedman over for the puck. Stamkos chasing after it. Played by Fleischman to Weiss. Harrison getting it at the point. His pass comes out of the zone as Campbell had backed off. Panthers tag up as Victor Hedman picks up the puck. Shots 19 apiece. 4-2 Panthers, though. Versteeg in the power play. Bergenheim indeed getting the unassisted shorthanded goal. Cutting in, Stamkos fires one and a blocker save there by Theodore. Away comes Weiss. Three-man rush with Thomas Fleischman. Winding, faking, Hedman reaching out and poking that puck away.
Marty tried to flip that puck out and hit Weiss on the leg as he was going off to the bench. He had one leg in the bench, one leg on the over the boards.
Icing the call here against the Lightning.
Kind of a dangerous play. The puck had stayed inside that offensive zone. For Florida, that is.
Guy Boucher, Marty Ramon talking things over in the Lightning bench. Now Dan Lacroix as they try to find a way out of a two-goal deficit here in the second period.
Trying to find a combination that's worked. So far, the 5 2/3 games that the Lightning have played, they haven't had a whole lot of combinations that have been really clicking at a great place. They have for stretches, but not totally.
Brewer gets the puck up the boards. Tap free by Connolly. Working with Malone. Juggles that puck on the blade of his stick. Avoided the hit from Booth. Connolly shooting, and Jovanovski deflects it out of play. And Jovanovski jousting a bit with Moore.
Everybody can be a tough guy in the league now.
Well, Chief, they call it the offseason, but for Tampa Bay's elite players, it's anything but a vacation. In the premiere episode of the Emmy Award-winning series Inside the Lightning, Sun Sports takes viewers inside the offseason training programs of Marty St. Louis, Steven Stamkos, Steve Downey, and new Lightning addition Ryan Shannon. How do the players prepare for the rigors of the 82-game regular season and playoffs? Find out on Inside the Lightning, the offseason, Thursday at 10:30 p.m. on Sun Sports, where hockey fans live. And that'll be right after the Lightning and Islanders. Paul Kennedy, videographer Jim Daly, producer Jeff DeMoss, putting together a very fascinating look behind the scenes of these guys. And don't miss that. Gotch in front. Gilly with a shot. Deflects over the net. Now as Bergenheim goes down, Rolison yelling at him. Away comes Connolly. Connolly across the line. Fires. Saved by Theodore. He juggled it, but hangs on as the traffic arrives. Now Weaver and Moore. Dominic Moore noted for getting under opponent's skin. He's doing just that.
Well, right now, you know, with just under 4 minutes to go, I mean, a little frustrated. They haven't had really any kind of sustained action inside that Florida zone in this period. Even though they've had 10 shots on goal, I think Theodore has done a better job of controlling the rebounds, or at least getting the rebounds to the side. And not many second chances.
Le Cavalier against Carter on this faceoff. Carter seeing action with three teams last year, the Ducks, the Canes, and then traded to the Panthers for Corey Stillman. As the Canes try to load up for down the stretch, missed the playoffs. Gilroy shooting, and it's deflected away by Bradley. He tosses away a broken stick. Purcell. Checked there by Mathias. It's tapped out to center. Gilroy bumps into Carter. angled the pass perfectly. LeCavalier cuts it, shoots, scores! What a play as it worked out. LeCavalier cutting in and goes over the shoulder of Theodore. The Lightning down one.
Boy, that's a huge goal. Big pass up the boards, too. Watch how the play evolves here. See this quick pass up the boards. It was really came off the boards hot, but it came right to Vinny LeCavalier. And then look at that quick shot right up over the glove hand of Theodore on the short side. And Vinny gets number two on the year and puts the Lightning within one to make the game 4-3.
Second goal for Vinny. You'll recall his first one in opening night in Raleigh. He batted in from the goal mouth. Versteeg chips the puck back in the Lightning zone for the Panthers. Picked up now by Weiss. Fleischmann shooting. Rollison the save. And Versteeg knocked down in his attempt to pick up the rebound. Stamkos right out of the stick to Hedman. St. Louis busting toward the net. Victor waiting. Beating it down low. St. Louis firing off the pads of Theodore. Garrison ahead for Fleischmann. Traded to Colorado in late November for Scott Hannon. Playing very well for the Avs, but then they discovered blood clots in his lungs, and he missed the rest of the season. Here's Stamkos cutting in, juggles that puck on the blade of his stick, couldn't get a shot it away as Booth takes it. Clark fires it away. It ends up with Kopetsky, however, the play's offside. Bergeron and Gilroy get the assists on Vinny's second at 16-21.
That was one of those plays, Rick, where you're really happy that you got a very lively side boards. Those quick bounce, not a real... See if any seam way here, and then he just waits just in time as it gets inside to Branson. And look at that quick shot, right up top, short side, over the glove.
Well, Gilroy and Hedman picking up their first points of the season. The Lightning have 19 players with at least a point. Puck taken by Kopetsky and flipped back to the corner. Gilroy's first Lightning point. And Bergeron's second assist of the night, giving him a team-leading 7 points. Panthers get Skilly on. Nice poke check by Nate Thompson. Play saved by Weaver. Skilly handing it to Weaver. Clark gets to the puck. Out for Teddy Persson. Here comes Thompson. Three Panthers back. Thompson joined by LeCavalier. Nate keeps it on the boards. Spins to try to lose Mike Weaver. Persson rifles it out of the reach of LeCavalier, but here comes Bergeron to poke it down the boards. Laid away by Kulikov. And Marcel Gotch to center. One-time Shark first rounder. Also with the Predators. And he stepped into there by Bergeron. Connolly pins his man along the end boards. Puck squirts free in front. Malone takes it. We're going to get a penalty here for a slash as the Lightning tried to cancel sticks. Trying to get to that loose puck in a dangerous area. And Dominic Moore heads off.
Lightning have had guys back in the zone, but they have not really been back with any purpose. A couple of times now that pass has come out into the slot area and they're kind of flat-footed, not anticipating the play. Watch it come here. There's the penalty right here. There's the slash. And it'll be Florida's fifth power play, 3-for-4 at this point. But you got to, in my mind, you got to be able to look and see how that play's developing. You got to get your body there a little sooner.
And the Lightning have a key penalty killer in the box and more. Adam Hall gets set up for this faceoff. 63% faceoff man in the early season, but he's taken a lot of draws. He's been sharp. Works against Weiss. Versteeg stepped in there. Panthers gain control. Weiss. Down to Chris Versteeg. 21 goals last year with the Leafs and the Flyers. And off to a good start with a couple of power play goals in this home-and-home series. That pass deflects back to Hedman. He'll wrist it down the ice with under a minute to go in the period. A
that's key right there. The Lightning have been a little slow in getting it down there. Victor took a couple of strides to get past it, a forechecker, and then got it clearly down the ice. You got to get down the ice with some kind of speed on it as well.
Puck deflects off Kulikov and out of play. Stay tuned for the Buick GMC second intermission report. Here's what's coming up. Sean Bergenheim wearing the wrong uniform. He'll be joining Paul at the intermission. Chris Dingman, Dave Andrichuk joined PK and Chief on the Telestrator. We've got stats as well. So a lot coming up. 1:22 left on the penalty and 43 and a half seconds remaining in the period. Kavina fires it off the official. Upshaw centers, backhand saved by Rollison off the blocker as Kopetsky was stopped in close. Rotola rifles it away. Ryan Campbell winds it up. Tremendous skater. Swings in. Trailed by Hall. Moves down to Kopetsky. Bark engages him. Thompson trying to win that puck. However, it rolled out to Garrison. Campbell hangs on to it. 5 seconds to go. Garrison missed the net. Stick side and Hall slips it out off Campbell over the blue line. And that'll do it for the second period. Lightning 13 shots and the Panthers 13 shots in that period. Vinny LeCavalier trying to bring the Lightning back from 2 goals down. The deficit at 1. 4-3 Panthers through 40 minutes here at the newly renovated St. Pete Times Forum. Lightning Hockey and Sun Sports is brought to you by Toyota. Moving forward. And by Steak and Shake. Life needs flavor. How about that view of downtown Tampa from the brand new party deck on the west side of the building here at the St. Pete Times Forum. Lightning down a goal. How about that, Chief? And now I can see why. That view has got to be why you would pick that as the best enhancement.
I got to make sure I got a parachute, though, when I go up there.
Okay. Don't give anybody any ideas here as we get ready to look at Chiefs highlights brought to you by Buick GMC dealers.
Well, you know, one of the things we talked about, Rick, and we're going to show it is the shorthanded goal. Bergenheim, this is something why he was so good for the Lightning here. Malone has the puck here. Now watch, as the puck will come here, it's going to bounce right here. Right here. You see it? And then Bergeron's really going to try and keep the puck in with his skates right about there. But, you know, he has struggles with it. And Bergenheim, watch how quickly he gets on it. And he just knocks it away. And he's got really good speed. So you're not going to catch him as he comes down. But as he gets to the goal, he gets ready to shoot. Now, watch up here. Watch the shoulders and watch the stick. What he does, he fakes the shoulders, fakes the forehand shot. And you'll see Rollison just move a little bit. And then Bergie will take it back here and then go right up top with it. Watch that. There's the shoulders. There's the forehand. See him moving a little bit now. He takes it over as he tries to get back there. And look at how high he gets that puck up to make sure that puck hits the top part of the net. Great play by Sean Bergenheim. That shorthanded goal gave the Panthers that 2-goal lead. But the key thing also on this play here for Lightning's goal, Vinny LeCavalier, they move the puck up very well. You see, the puck bounces off the boards. Now you see Purcell's right here. Branson thinks it's going to come here, but the puck is going to bounce this way right past him. Take a look. You see he gets caught, and he just can't reach it. That gives Vinny LeCavalier right down the left side of the rink, and he comes in, and he just puts it right up over top of that shoulder to get the Lightning within one. Tremendous play on the part of LeCavalier, but this a youngster not reading the boards right. But this one here, this is why Ford has been so good against the Lightning right now. Here the first shot comes right through. Kabina's trying to clear. It's going to hit the referee up here. But look at here. You got one guy here. You got this guy on the puck very, very quickly, and he's going to pick it up right here. Two guys on the puck here right off the bat. See how quickly they get to it? And as he comes back here, now we stop it here. Here's our back checker, and here's Kopetsky. You got to get over just a little bit closer than that. He's got this man. Now you've got to go over and get this man. They just get a little bit slow to get to him. And there you see the rebound will come by here. And then the board right here is just going to take the piece of the stick right off, actually, the outside of the glove. And knocks it off the post, or off the side of the net, rather. And they do not fail to score. But I'll tell you what, the Panthers been on that puck, tuning on that puck very, very quickly.
To update the numbers, brought to you by your local Buick GMC dealers. And the shots 13 apiece in the second. Panthers with the edge in scoring chances, and certainly they have found success. 3 of 4 in the power play and a shorthanded goal, and they have the slight edge in faceoffs won. The Lightning blocking plenty of shots once again as we revisit the Ottawa poll question, which will be the best part of the Forum's renovation. If you believe the pipe organ, which you can hear in the background right now, TB1, TB2, the Tesla coils, TB3, new seats, TB4, outdoor party deck, 789-789. The number to text your selection to, the pass to Fleischman, he bobbled it, and he got bumped by Hall as the Panthers continue on their fifth power play chance here with Dominic Moore in the box for slashing. 20 seconds remaining in the penalty. The pass to Fleischman steps in. Beating it now. The shot by Verstegi scores. Chris Verstegi scored again. And another power play goal for the Panthers. They're back in front by two again at 5-3.
Well, the first time he got the pass and he came down that right side, he looked like he had more room and he didn't go. He tried to pass it back, but watch this time. When they get the pass right through the middle, he gets it. And again, short side, high over the glove. Bang, it's in there. And Verstegi picks up his second of the night, third on the season. But take a look at this Foxmole right there. Just beats him underneath the glove and over the left pad. So power play goal number four.
Harrison sends it in. Five special teams goals for the Panthers in this game for the power play. Stamp goes back for the Lightning. And the pass intended for Cabina was knocked away by Skilly. Skilly walks in. Tangled up with Clark. And they wrestle him out of the way as Cabina takes over. Fleischman and Weiss will get the assists on the goal by Versteeg. This is a line that has been anointed number one by the media. Kevin Dineen doesn't admit to that, but you got your leading scorer from last year as the centerman. That's the way most people will look at it. Boy, they've been productive here in the early season. That shot by Bergenheim goes wide, picked up by Upshaw and taken out by Marc-Andre Bergeron.
Not only did they score four goals on the power play and a one shorthanded goal, but on the power play, 12 of their 22 shots have come with the man advantage. 5-on-5, they haven't been a whole lot. They haven't had to. That power play has been outstanding.
Didn't they have 18 shots in the power play on Saturday?
Pretty close.
Gilroy gets to it. Gilroy sliding at the center. Two Panthers collide. That shook up Upshaw briefly as he was bumped by Booth. Teddy Purcell walks in. Wrists it. Blocker saved by Theodore. Rebound kept away from Thompson. Two Panthers defending there. David Booth down the left side. Pass across for Upshaw and the play's offside.
Just that play right there, you see the Lightning gaining the zone. Panthers had four guys back on a three-man rush. They disrupted the rush, but then they returned 3-on-2 of an odd rush themselves. Only going offside prevented them from having an opportunity on goal. But they have done it both ends of the rink. And Kevin Dineen talked about that with me this morning, about how he has to get all the guys back. He says, I don't think our team has played a full 60 minutes, but we're getting there. And we have to make sure that we understand that we've got to come back in the zone and help out our D. And very similar to what Guy Boucher and his staff wants the Lightning to play like.
Panthers split their first two games, winning on the island at opening night, 2-0 a Theodore shutout, and then losing 4-2 in Pittsburgh before the home-and-home with the Lightning. On December 4th, St. Pete Times Forum and Opera Tampa are proud to present Andrea Bocelli in one of only six American tour dates this year, accompanied by a 71-piece orchestra and 60-person choir. You don't want to miss this opera legend. Great seats are available by calling 800-745-3000 or by visiting Ticketmaster.com. That's Bradley. He'll chip it in deep in the Lightning zone. Rollison ready to play it. Couldn't get it by Carter. Picked up by Matthias. Couldn't step in front. Connolly takes it. Bradley comes by for it. Cabina poked it off his stick. Dominic Moore plays it off the boards to center. Campbell chops it back toward his defense partner, Jason Garrison. Cabina with a hit on Carter reacted angrily to that. Brewer slips the check of Bradley. Ryan Shannon on the move. He's got an assist in this game. Ian Purcell back in for Blair Jones and Tom Pyatt. Bruno Bichurbe joining them as a healthy scratch. And Matias Olin on the men from knee surgery. Brewer an effective hit there on Kulikov. And Brewer's got the puck. Bertola on the one touch, kept in by Weiss. Fleischman shoots, and it's gloved by Rolison. And he'll hang on. For in-depth coverage of tonight's game, pick up tomorrow's St. Petersburg Times, the official newspaper of the Tampa Bay Lightning and their fans. To subscribe, call 877-THE-TIMES or visit TampaBay.com.
Panthers doing a good job. They're really showing their speed. You know, getting back defensively, we talked about, Rick, but also getting on their transition game to get up, get to the offense as well. But the thing that they've been most impressive so far in this game to me has been the fact that they've really put two guys on that puck all the time in the offensive zone.
Jovanovski tips that Stamkos shot out of play. Five of the last six games between these teams have gone to overtime. That would look pretty good for the Lightning right now.
Well, Jovanovski, is interesting note about him. You know, he scored that goal, the first goal of the game in Florida. And that was the last time he scored for the Panthers was 12 years ago. 9 months, 14 days.
Wonder if he remembers it.
Sure he did. I bet he remembered a lot. He played his first 3 or 4 years with the Panthers when he was a number one draft pick today.
He used to fairly regularly score double figures in goals. He was quite a threat. As a tough defenseman and a guy who brought a lot of offense to the job as well. Things have settled down for him a little bit offensively in his 5 years with the Phoenix Coyotes before coming back to South Florida. Puck chipped off the glass by Fleischman, picked up by Hedman. Hands it now to LaCavalier. Garrison takes it, back around to Campbell. Marcel Gotch. They're missing Mike Santarelli, who's out with a shoulder injury until later on this month. You've got to wonder what's going to happen to the center ice position for the Panthers when he is ready to return.
They had Scotty Upshaw playing there, you know, as well as Kopechki. So they've had a couple of guys that usually play the wing play in that position.
Purcell on the forecheck. And an errant pass stolen by Ryan Malone. Fires right through the crease. And it deflects back to the point. Gilroy gets to it at center. Jovanovski tips that puck. It comes across to Bergenheim. Couldn't get enough on it to clear. And the shot is taken by Bergeron and fired wide. Jack Skilly met by Connolly and very assertively chopped the puck away. Moore swings in, leans in, cuts it, stopped by Theodore as he kept the stick down. Hedman steps into that shot, saved by Theodore, and no rebound with Malone lurking.
Much better pressure that time, and you know, getting in on that puck carrier a little quickly. You'll have to try and take some chances now. You know, when you're down by two, you're going to have to be a little bit more aggressive offensively. Watch this play coming in. Theodore does a nice job of getting that paddle down, but he kind of deflected that shot. It was trying to go for the five hole before it got there. But again, take the puck to the net. Good things don't happen.
Bergeron fires off the post. Rebound. That stopped in front as it was fired toward the net by Ryan Shannon. Weaver. Barry St. Louis on the hit. Marty's still in there working while prone on the ice. He got it to Shannon. Now in front. The shot by Stamkos is stopped by Theodore. It comes to Brewer. Bergeron rifles that one wide. Kopechki trying to get to it. He's able to poke it down the ice. Bergeron and Booth shoulder to shoulder into that corner. Brewer ahead for St. Louis. Stamkos throws it to open ice. And the play is offside.
Let's take a look at our Ottawa replay. And it's so important how we talk about faceoffs. Look at this. The Lightning get it on the faceoff. It'll come back. The shot will come right off the goalpost. But not only that, then that was a quick chance on the part by Shannon, who tried to get it up high over the fallen goalie. Watch this shot right off the post, dead off. Actually hit the skate of St. Louis, and then Shannon just missed on his try to get it up high to get the Lightning within one. That's our Ottawa replay.
putting those shifts back to back has been an issue, and the Lightning will try to do that now with Rotola, Hall, and Downey. And Hall getting it in front, poked away by Theodore, and it bounced off Garrison. Tap to the point. Edmund saw that coming, and he'll pitchfork it back in behind the net. Campbell belted by Downey. Kilroy into the action. Finds Matias Rotola. Rotola turns, trying to fire. Taken over by Campbell. Flips it into the Lightning zone. Matias can't get by Hedman. Victor in a strong play. Makes the feed to Rotola. Could handle the puck. It rolls back to Gabranson. Shots 26-23 favoring the Lightning, but it's a 5-3 Panther lead. As Clark will take it. Panthers changing up ice. The Lightning get fresh forwards on. Thompson, LeCavalier, Persilon. Clark keeps going. Tried to center it. Hit Gabranson. Fleischman leads it ahead for Weiss. Thompson there in position. Teddy Purcell takes Clark's pass. In the middle of the ice, the Panthers clawed that up. Fleischman getting it down to Dmitry Kulikov, former first rounder. He'll send it wide of Rolison. It plops in behind the net, dribbled out to Rolison, and he pins it at the side of the goal. The Panthers lead by two.
The Lightning of the game, and it's got to go to the Florida Panthers special teams. Four power play goals, one short and a goal. The first one deflected off Topetsky, and then Versteeg with two power play goals. And then this one here by Sean Bergenheim, a shorthanded goal. And as you see there, the four power play goals, one shorthanded goal. All special teams resulted in the goals for the Panthers, and that's our Ackerman Jewelers Diamond Performance of the Game.
Thunderbug up above the Between the Pipes bar that's located right below the new pipe organ. Trying to get the crowd going. Sellout anticipated. New sellout capacity number, 19,204, as the number the Lightning have taken out seats. Both in suites to create more room and more open atmosphere in some of the corners in the concourse level, as well as those sections where you saw Thunderbug trying to juice the crowd a little bit in the terrace level. Dominic Moore sends the puck in. Dabrowski back. Branson couldn't handle it. Stamkos sends it toward the net, and it bounced off Jovanovski to the corner. He'll flip it to center. Bergenheim drives it back in, handled by Jose Theodore. Theodore with the Minnesota Wild last year. Gave them pretty good work in behind Nicklas Backstrom. Puck pushed toward Downey. Picked up by Gilroy. Gilroy neatly steps away from Bergenheim. Gilroy, after a couple of years of the Rangers, now with the Lightning as Downey. Chip in charge, joined by St. Louis. Takes on Kulikov. Gotch slips free. Down he goes, a penalty upcoming. I think it's going to Downey. He's complaining. Meanwhile, Skilling with the backhand, a save by Rolison. And the puck comes down to Downey. And he throws the puck, and he's fortunate. The puck hit a Panther player and not in the direction of Kyle Raymond, as it's Downey going off at 8:33.
When they were going for the puck, it might be a high sticking call. Watch Gotch going for the pie right there.
Penalty number 9, 2 minutes, high sticking.
The stick came up rather high. The Lightning shorthanded here for the sixth time.
Well, Downey quickly moving to the front of the penalty minute race for the Lightning, certainly. 31 minutes on the season. Picking up a misconduct earlier tonight, and now the minor penalty. The story is the Panthers 4-5 with a man advantage, and they have an opportunity here. Kulikov gave it up under pressure from Thompson. Hall joined by Hedman on the rush. He knows the deal. The Lightning down two and about 11 minutes to go in the third, as well as being down a man. Campbell at spinorama. Certainly perfected it in his days with the Sabres, and I'm sure wasn't judged quite as well on it in Chicago, where Denny Savard made it famous. Here's a shot tipped wide by Weiss, and Rollison a stop there, and a shot taken from the far side by Versteeg, who's got two goals in this contest. The puck played down the ice by Shannon.
In fact, you know, that goal he scored against the Lightning in Florida was a one-timer as well on the power play. So we've seen him score three goals like that now. But we saw Stamkos score in abundance.
Kopetsky back out to Jovanovski. Shooting directed on goal by Upshaw, and Rolison made the stop. Puck kept in by the Panthers. Brewer trying to get a stick on it. Kopetsky comes up with it. Worked free by St. Louis. 30 seconds to go on the penalty. Boost stop point blank by Rolison. Big save there. And St. Louis from center chips it into the Panther bench. With 23 to go on the call against Steve Downey.
What, two big saves by Rolison. The first one was one where he had to come across quickly. There you see the deflection, and he got it with his glove. It was Upshaw bidding to get that fifth power play goal. Then this one here, probably the best opportunity. Booth kicking it to the backhand. Only following him all the way, not allowing him to get any kind of open air. Put that puck through.
Campbell takes it. Room to roam through center. Gilroy challenged by Bergenheim. Worked free by Bergeron, and now LeCavalier will backhand it down the ice. Ian Stamkos late in this penalty kill, and they'll be joined by Steve Downey out of the box. And here he comes. Lightning kill the penalty. Florida 4 of 6 on the power play. Skilly angles it behind it. Downey takes it. Ahead for Vinny. LeCavalier's goal, bringing the Lightning to within one. That was earlier. It's now a two-goal deficit again. Gilroy well covered by Skilly. Gilroy fires it for... They score! Stamkos rifles it home on a one-timer. It's a 5-4 game.
What a pass by Matt Gilroy. Boy, that thing was right on the tape. It was on the tape with some... oomph to it as well. Take a look here. There it is, a quick pass right to him. There is no opportunity at all for Theodore to get over that quickly. Stamkos putting the Lightning in one, but Matt Gilroy picks up his second assist of the night, and that one was a tremendous pass. And you can even see after the goal was scored how Stamkos went over to him and said, great pass. 10:53 the time.
St. Louis right back for the Lightning. It's saved by Theodore. The puck loose. Malone got it free. Now he's tangled up. And worked free by Kulikov. Lightning trying to strike very quickly. As it's lifted in by Bradley. Stamkos from Gilroy and Bergeron. Those two productive defensemen continue to help out on the attack. Brett Clark to center. Stopped by Matthias. Clark got it free. Lightning down a goal. 8.5 to go in the third period. Weaver back. Moore keeps him honest. Matthias. And look out. He lobbed it into the Panther bench. Now the Lightning twice have crept back within a goal. Can they get all the way back?
22. That's the number the Lightning are really paying attention to. The down by one, as you see there. And that's the time remaining third period. Marc-Andre Bergeron. 3 assists tonight. He's up his team leading lead to 8 points, as you see there. 10 shots on goal. And the man they brought in last year from Montreal to provide some offense from that blue line has certainly picked it up here early in the season here to this year.
Chief, those numbers are identical to what he had in 23 games in the regular season last year. 2 goals, 6 assists, 8 points. There's still time for more scoring heroics in this, the 6th game of this season. Here he is making a catch, dropped his stick. And the Panthers playing it back to center. Weiss takes it, chopped away at the line by Hedman. Pass to Purcell, speeding through around the stick. He shoots it, it's by the glove of Theodore and out of play. And Kyle Raymond indicates it was deflected out.
Well, one of the things, too, you know, he was coming off a major knee surgery as well. And it takes a while for you to get back into play, even though you might feel good and your rehab has come well. But Bergeron, I think you got to get that year under your belt. We've seen it with Vinny LeCavalier. It took him to the last almost a half a year there to get over all the surgeries he had. But Bergeron seems to be a lot healthier player this year than last.
Downey to Stamko shooting. Stopped by Theodore at the side. Lost track of the puck once again. Kulikov with a strong defensive play against Stamkos. That puck ends up in the seats among the Lightning jersey-clad season ticket holders. That new microchip in the sleeve.
It's been a really a kind of an odd game in a sense. We've seen teams go in waves. Tim, the Lightning seem to get things going to get within one, then a power play results. And that power play for the Panthers has been outstanding here tonight.
Lightning have been outstanding in the third period so far. Stamkos off the LeCavalier pass, bats it wide. Coming into this game, as the Panthers ice the puck, Lightning had scored 14 goals, 7 in the third period. They scored a big one here in the third. It's the return of the Empire State. The Islanders taking on the Lightning Thursday night at 7:30. Then it's the Lightning and the Sabres Saturday night at 7. Take note of that. Be the Thunder behind the Lightning during opening week. Here at the St. Pete Times Forum, get tickets now by calling 800-745-3000 or visit Ticketmaster.com. Faceoff won by the Lightning. Bergeron steps into it. It's deflected over the net by Bergenheim. Clark with it. Wrist to get saved by Theodore off the stick through several pairs of legs. Bergenheim sliding it back to center. Seeing the lead across to Bergeron. Shannon stepping into St. Louis, goes back in, trying to curl it back. A diving Weaver ends up on top of the puck. And we get Dominic Moore involved. It finally comes loose. Clark shooting save by Theodore. Clark lines again. That drive deflected wide. Loose behind the net. Shannon wins the race for it. Moore with it. Curling out of the corner. Matched up with Kulikov. Moore keeps the play alive. Bergeron with it. Clark closely watched by Skilly. Angled it. St. Louis shoots. Save. Rebound. Theodore the stop there. Waiting for a whistle. There it is, with St. Louis and Shannon burrowing their way in, looking for a loose puck. Moore involved, and the Lightning really gunning for that tying goal.
Well, I'll tell you what, they look at Clark trying to get it off the end boards in a heads-up play. The quick shot, watch it. I think it hit right in the mask, right there, boom, right off the shoulder and part of the mask. And then Moore trying to jam that puck loose to keep it going. Shannon in the front there as well. There's the shot off the shoulder, part of the mask. They just couldn't quite get it past.
Kilroy, the shot is saved by Theodore. He stopped the rebound by Malone. Another face-off win by the Lightning. They're red hot in the circle. Hedman off the boards to center. Update on the shots as the Lightning have surged in front with 11 here in the third period. And the Panthers have 6.
They've done a very good job 5-on-5, the Lightning. You know, they've really generated a lot of shots, a lot of offensive pressure. Coming in tonight, only Pittsburgh, Colorado, and St. Louis have scored more goals than the Lightning. So goal scoring hasn't been a problem for them in the early part of this year.
Campbell angles it by Mathias. Rolison will play it. As he saw, they waved off icing. That shot by Mathias misfired. Gets it back from Carter. He's got Bradley with him waiting in front of the net. And Hedman wrangling there with Mathias. He cycled it down to Ryan Carter. Minnesota native out to Weaver. Malone trying to get out there and cover the point. That shot deflected by Thompson. Malone got taken down from the point. Here's the shot that's wide by Garrison. Mathias with Bradley parked in front. Dobanovsky coming off the bench now for the Panthers. Mathias wheeling with it. Finally bumped off the play by Malone. Puck regained by Carter. Good session once again with his fourth line for Kevin Dineen. Malone out to center. Couldn't slide it in deep. Quick change by the Lightning. Puck angled well out of the reach of Mathias. And we'll get an icing called against Florida with 5:10 to go in the third. And a big face-off in the Panthers zone with the Lightning down a goal. World Wrestling Entertainment action returns to the St. Pete Times Forum Monday, December 5th at 8:15 p.m. with WWE Raw Super Show featuring Triple H, John Cena, the Divas, and more. Tickets are on sale now for as little as $20. Visit Ticketmaster.com and cheat that number 800-745-3000.
Florida had to take a timeout there. He had that one line out there that had probably the most offensive pressure in the Lightning zone in this third period, but when they got back, the icing call, so they got to give them a little bit of a breather.
Now, see Boucher diagramming something here as the Lightning try to climb back even in this game. Panthers open the scoring. The Lightning tied it, took their lead at 14 minutes of the first period on the goal by Hedman. But then Florida scored the next two goals, and the next three goals make it to lead by two. Bergenheim gave them a 4-2 lead in the second. LeCavalier cut that down to a goal. Another power play goal by Versteeg early in the third. And the Panthers had a 5-3 advantage. Stamkos answering from Gilroy and Bergeron at 10:53. Stephen's second of the season. Makes it a 5-4 game. The officials talking with Kevin Dineen. Maybe about the players who were on the ice at the time of the icing call. Of course, you can't substitute in that situation. That's why he would have been forced to use that timeout.
Well, also, too, he's doing a really good job of giving him a little extra time to get rested, too.
I think that's the longest rest Campbell's had all night.
I think so. Kevin's no stranger to the coaching ranks. 6 years he spent in Portland. Four of those 6 years, his team won over 40 games.
LeCavalier set the duel on this draw. Panthers come up with it. Kovanovsky can't get to it. He put down Steve Downey in his efforts to get to the puck. It's right back into the action. LeCavalier poking it back to the point. Handled by Stamkos, but he couldn't keep it in. Marc-Andre Bergeron, three assists on the night. Downey to center. Stripped by Fleischman. Recovered by LeCavalier. Downey trying to send in Stamkos. That was taken over by Versteeg. Versteeg, a Bruin draft pick. Now he centers. Weiss shooting, scores! Steven Weiss has made it another two-goal Panther lead with 4:32 to go in the third at 6-4.
The guy that got in and got the puck was Versteeg. Chris Versteeg. Watch how they dump the puck in. He goes and gets it. Lightning lose the battle. You see the puck will come here. All Weiss does is go right to the front of the net, as does his line mate, and then bang. Everybody's very, very slow in getting there. Weiss picks up his second goal of the game, third of the season. And there you see our Fox Mall right there as he puts it on. The Lightning are down by two again with 4.5 to go.
That line has produced 8 points. Gabina going to work the way along the board. Skilly's attempt to clear, hit more, and went out of play. 4:22 to go in the third. The deficit once again two for the Lightning.
Look at our tonight's freeze cam brought to you by Coors Light. It's going to be that one-timer by Steven Stamkos just rallying it home. The Lightning 5-1. But watch the torque on his stick. Look at it. The big bend there, and you can see why he has a tremendous shot. Giving Theodore no time. That's our Coors Light freeze cam. Brought to you by Coors Light Frosted Brew for your enjoyment.
Stamkos looking on that last scoring play. Weiss's third goal, second of the night. Versteeg and Jovanovski pick up the assists at 15-28 to make it 6-4. And Hedman with the puck. We've got a whistle and a tripping indication. And Pavel Kabina complaining about this call on his way to the box.
Well, I tell you, this is something. 15:52. Seventh power play, four for six. The bulk of the shots have come with the man advantage.
Panthers, as Rolison makes a save, puck was played out of play by Brewer. And he batted it over the glass and out of play directly. It's a delay of game penalty. And 10 seconds into the cabina call, the Lightning will be shorthanded on the Brewer delay call.
Wow.
That's the second delay of game penalty of that type for the Lightning tonight. Gilroy got one in the first period.
Watch the rebound coming out there, and he just tried to knock it up in the air, and he did. But he knocked it too well.
Panthers coming into this power play at 20 scoring chances overall, but only 6 at even strength. The rest coming on the power plays, and obviously that shorthanded goal by Bergenheim. So a 5-on-3 for the Panthers. Lightning have survived a couple of these situations here in the early season. Puck cleared by Thompson. Campbell through center for the Panthers. Into the zone along with Weiss. Angles it around for Versteeg. Garrison. Now to Campbell. Watched by Adam Hall. They score! Garrison fires it home off the pass from Campbell. A 5-on-3 power play goal. 7-4 Panthers. And it's now 5 goals with a man advantage.
I don't think they'll be practicing this tomorrow. 16:47. Take a look. That quick shot coming right through. I think it might even hit Booth in front. You see the pass coming right here. Garrison taking the shot, who has a real good shot. He plays not only the power play, but kills penalty as well.
This is an undrafted free agent who, over the last 3 years, has worked his way into the lineup. Peter DeBoer used him quite a bit with Mike Weber on a pair last year, and now Kevin Dineen's using him even more. They whistle down offside. Garrison scoring from Campbell and Versteeg at 16:42.
This is incredible, the number of points these guys are picking up.
Now the Panthers now on their 8th opportunity, 5 of 7 in this game, 2 of 6 on Saturday. At 7 of 13 in the home-and-home series after starting the year 1 for 10 in their first two games. Kulikov through center. He'll chip it off the glass. Kabina getting to it. Kabina spills his man. Mathias behind the net. Or Epshaw, pardon me, as out comes Stamkos with St. Louis. Down goes Marty off the confrontation with Jovanovski. Puck comes out and it's handled by the Panthers' Matt Bradley. Mathias will take it. Back to Bradley, taken over by Gilroy with 2:10 to go. And 11 seconds remaining on the penalty to Eric Brewer. The pass through to St. Louis from the sharp angle, saved by Theodore. Jason Garrison ahead for Carter. Out of the box comes Brewer. Carter with a pass blocked by Gilroy. Carter gets it back. Poked free by Matt Gilroy, and Brewer, who remains out there. And with Rolison playing it to Hedman. Long lead pass ahead for Vinny, trying to straddle that blue line. Mathias getting it to Carter. Steps in, shoots. Handled by Rolison with 1:37 to go. Let's have a look at our 3 stars brought to you by Steak and Shake.
Well, as you can bet, it's all Florida. Their third star, Steven Weiss, with 2 goals and 2 assists. Campbell, with all that ice time, picked up 4 assists as well. But Versteeg, with his 2 power play goals and 2 assists, he's the guy that kind of put them on the front end of the engine most of the night when he kept scoring those power play goals early.
Bergeron rifles the pass ahead for Brett Connolly. Jovanovski cuts across for it. Connolly pressuring him along with LeCavalier. Bergenheim gets it into the hands of the responsible Marcel Gotch, German-born centerman. Bergeron, nice night offensively, but certainly looking for the win in this home opener for the Lightning. As Bergeron, three assists on the night. Trebanowski's got a pair of helpers. His pass around to Bergenheim. He stepped into there by Purcell, or by Dominic Moore, with under a minute to go in the game. Skilly from center. In on Rollison. Bergeron ahead for Malone. On the move, it's Moore. He's got Rotolo with him. Five men back for the Panthers. Stepping off the Lightning bench, Brett Clark. They'll poke it behind the net. Kulikov challenged by Moore. Weaver dumped there by Rotolo, and he's going to get a penalty. 31.1 to play. Boarding will be the call from Brad Meyer. This will be the ninth power play for the Florida Panthers.
19:28 is the time. He pushes him into the boards. He was looking. I don't think he saw Rotolo coming. And that's the thing they're trying to get the players to be more cognizant of, making sure when guys are in a vulnerable position, you got to lay off them.
Weiss wins the faceoff. Fleischman down low to Versteeg. Bounced back to Gabranson. Worked free by Adam Hall. Thompson with him. Gilroy stepping ahead as well. Thompson slips around Weiss. He shoots a save by Theodore off the blocker. Centered in front. Gilroy fires. Save by Theodore. Tap free. Fleischman has it. 8 seconds remaining. Panthers will move to 3-1. With the win, they will play the Caps tomorrow night at the Verizon Center. The Lightning fall to 1-3-2, 4 points. And we'll try to regroup against the Islanders on Thursday night. The Sabres coming in Saturday here in this three-game homestand to start the home season. Well, the Panthers explode for 5 power play goals, a shorthanded goal, defeat the Lightning by the score of 7-4. And we've got Lightning Live coming up next here from the St. Pete Times Forum.